This morning, the Bonnet Carre Spillway was opened for the 12th time in its history. The Army Corps opened 8 of the 350 bays today and planned to open 100 of them in total to relieve pressure from the levees in the metro area. And tonight, water from the rising Mississippi River is flowing through that spillway.
Paul Murphy joins us from the spillway with concerns about potential environmental impacts. Good evening, Paul.
Good evening, Tom. Karen, with only 8 of the bays open right now, we are expecting additional bays, maybe up to 100, 150 bays to be open over the next 2 weeks as needed. Let me step out and let you take a live look at what we're seeing right now. As you can see, water is now rushing into the spillway, flowing from the Mississippi River to Lake Pontchartrain. Water from the rising Mississippi River is now flowing at a rate of more than 11,000 cubic feet per second through the Bonnet Carre Spillway northwest of New Orleans. The structure diverts a portion of the water into Lake Pontchartrain. The spillway is designed to ease pressure on local levees and help prevent flooding downriver. The Army Corps of Engineers is aware of environmental concerns every time the spillway opens.
Every time we operate the spillway, it has a slightly different effect on Lake Pontchartrain based on the time of year, the temperature of the water, the amount of water put through the spillway.
Coastal scientist Dr. John Lopez says fresh water from the river will actually replace all of the brackish water in the lake within a few weeks' time.
So basically all the normal lake water that has a little bit of salinity and also some of the fish species and things associated with it tend to be pushed out.
Nutrients in the river water can also result in algae blooms down the line when the brackish water returns to the lake. Dr. Lopez says the additional algae can also be a good thing, often increasing the overall productivity of the Pontchartrain Basin.
Those nutrients basically, they do create algae, sometimes too much, but that algae is also the base of the food chain. So small organisms eat the algae, larger organisms eat those organisms, and so forth.
Opening the Bonnet Carre could also push certain types of wildlife out of their normal habitat as water fills up the mile-wide, 6-mile-long spillway.
We're going to have airboats right behind the structure to capture and return to the Mississippi any endangered pallid sturgeon that happened to come through the structure.
And the Army Corps rescued 9 sturgeon when the spillway opened in 2016 and 20 in 2011. And the spillway is expected to remain open for up to 3 weeks. Now, it's been